Hello for Thursday, October 27th, and we had a rally of 162 points. Not so unusual, though I'd hoped that we wouldn't just turn right around the next day. So, of course, we had that in the past back here at the beginning of August, you know, when we drop a big amount one day and up the same amount, then down the same amount, then up the same amount. And I mean, great for trading if you're a short-term and futures trading, but everyone else goes a little nuts over it. Anyway, we did the same thing. We just reversed. Nothing came out of the summit that means much, but maybe someone will make something of it. It's just putting things off to the future. We'll do something. Just give us time, and you know, and we'll see if the market may react negatively to it. But at the moment, it's still hanging in there. Okay, we can look at the futures on that on the Dow, and you can see. During the day, it was all right. It made up this high, and it dropped pretty precipitously, and it looked like, oh, this would be good. Maybe it can get down to some kind of projections like this. When it got to this level, this didn't show the projections, but on the right side, you can see that. We hope that maybe from the time frame we were looking at, maybe the 50% at least, but no, it couldn't even get there. Instead, it moved back up. It rallied up to its 38% and then came down, made a little bit higher low. But a lot of people look for these double bottoms, and that indeed was a good buy. And you can see it rallied up, and just before the close, it did move higher. And just after the close, it moved higher still, and it's pulled back. And at the moment, it's 11.819 as you see it. And on the SPX, the weekly chart, we're just above that trend line, and we'll just see, show you on the futures. It's about the same as the Dow. In other words, the pattern. The one thing being different, it didn't. You can't see it. It's below this where I can show you. My screen is not high enough, but it didn't drop quite as much as the Dow, and didn't rally back up to about 50% retrace of the total drop. Came again for a little double bottom, higher bottom, and then it rallied up nicely. So if you're trading futures, you did okay on that. While we're at it, we'll show you the Russell. And in the bottom half, you can see the NASDAQ 100, very similar, not much to show. We'll post these charts later, and of course, some of them have been posted on the stream, and you can just find them there if there's something particular you need to see about it. But you can see we have, it did move up slightly above the 725 in the Russell, and the 127 is at 130. Let's see if we can see it. Right there, 139, I think it is. That's a possibility. 130.5. So that's an area to watch. If on the overnight we do creep up there again, that could be some resistance at 730.5. And the 161 is at 737. Okay, on other matters, we had the dollar. Stayed about the same. The gold did move up here, the gold futures, and you can see it added another 1% up, about $20. We are getting up over the top Bollinger Band here, and the volume was a little lighter. So that's kind of a caution that we may have some sideways, or we may even pull back a little bit. We may have a chart of GLD we can show as well. And show on it, we had a projection, same would have been with gold itself, but on GLD you can see from this range that it was in before, this line up here to this line down here, going back up, it retraced 100%, and then 127% is where we hung for a while and just slightly broke over. So if that does go above this level, then we're looking at $170.35 would be the 161.8. Those would be the levels to watch, 167 and 170. And so with gold being strong, GDX continued up as well. And so regardless of if you bought down at the very change or if you missed it by a buck or something upside, you're still in good shape as it closed at 50, almost $58. So if you got it at 55, you're still up $3. And SLV, same, went up not very much, only 7 cents of the day, but it's looking okay. So if we look at the stocks from the watch list, there are not a lot of triggers. There's a lot of stocks that were up big, but none of them were great entry points. They were just, you know, they weren't like breakouts. I mean, you know, they weren't set up like this where you have a clean break. They're just stocks that just started from wherever. They didn't just rally big. But not many from our list like that. So the double for gold was up a little higher than this, and then it pulled back, and which is quite often. So, but the main thing is, if it can hold above this 50-day, then you can take some entries on that if you think that gold is going higher. GDX in the candlestick chart, you can see we showed you before that didn't move up a lot, so it's just kind of hanging there right at the 50 and 200 days. So if it resolves to the upside, it could have okay run, because quite often when they're touching, you know, that can create fireworks. And CDE for silver, that one also kind of stayed stationary. USU, I think if this breaks, we can look at the 230 or maybe up as high as the 246, the top of the top Bollinger band there. The volume's been pretty steadily nice the last couple of days. So do pay attention, though, to earnings. We're going to show you why in a moment. But you need to do that. FSII, this one moved up nicely, about 5.5%. And these low-priced ones tend to be doing this. So this one, we're looking for a move maybe up to the 239 where it was before, or above the 240 where we have the line there. FCS was another one that did the move up about 5.5%. It did close just slightly over the 200-day, but we did post this chart as it got to it saying, you know, don't let it slip under, because you want to at least keep your day trading. Always re-enter it later. So the one we did wanted to mention, I don't have this in after hours, but this is one we were waiting for because it looked pretty good, except for we didn't like this long down candle. So we've been saying, and this didn't, lately we thought over 725 might be an entry here if it had good volume. Didn't make it above there. But they reported earnings after hours, and I think they're down in the high fives, something. They were down quite a bit, so we're not interested until it maybe sets up again, but at the moment we're not. So, but that's an idea that reminds you, just don't buy something and hold it. This one didn't trigger, but yet, but anything that you do buy, make sure that you don't get caught and not know that they're reporting earnings and find out it's down. Okay, some additions here. We're only adding a couple, a few, because of it's late and we've got a lot of them that are really ready. ACLS, another low-priced one, but look at this volume on it. Normally it's like 500,000 shares, and it did 1.5 million. It moved up. You can see there's levels above here. It's at 138, but you've got a 144 or 150 level. So it percentage-wise, it's already up 13%. Maybe it'll have to go sideways again, but it looks like when it does this kind of move after this consolidation right here at the 20-day, and now it's broken over the 50-day the first time since July. So this one might get some legs and move up higher. Anyway, if you're interested in the low price ones, that is a possibility. CYT, the higher price. But this is also kind of a short-term trade. You can see here, got as high as 45.42. But this level is a little bit shorter. It's shy of that level. It got as high during at 44.71. So over about 45. This may run up to this 47.37 is a 200-day. So just a couple of dollars off here. What's that, 5%? It could be a quick move. It had very good volume coming into this consolidation, so it definitely could run up there, maybe higher. But that would be the start of it right there. So that's one to put on the watch list, pay attention to, as is NUGT. Another one that's being held down by the 50-day. And the 50 is under the 200-day, which is negative, but it's had good volume now at the moment, and you can see the slight turn up in the 20-day. So if this thing starts moving higher, the 50-day is going up faster than the 200-day, which means if it got up as high as like this 36, they'd probably almost be crossing. Depends on when that happened. But anyway, at the moment, just looking for a move over this area. The high of the day was 32.40. If it can break above the 50-day, which is at 32.45, we might get a run the first dollar up to the 200-day, and then maybe some continuation from there. And another stock would be HNPT. And it's 594 was the high of the day, so above 594 and then to 617. But if it can get much above it, then we've got this long red candle, it could go up to maybe 650, 675. But it really depends on what the follow through is from this point. It may go sideways a little bit, that'd be beneficial. But you can see Williams indicators just started to turn up at the moment. So, anyway, that's what we have for Thursday. I hope you have a great day trading. Thanks a lot for watching. and we will send tweets out during the day and have charts on view, so pay attention to those as well, because sometimes they're helpful. You know, when you're watching charts, sometimes you're waiting for the setup, and it seems boring and you wait, but then when it comes, like double bottoms and that kind of thing, is then it's worth the wait, because you have good entry points and you can make some quick cash. So thanks a lot. Have a great day. Talk to you later. Bye.